Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Amma ba'd, habatafillah, a question was asked. When I was younger, I used to go to this local masjid. I was a tablighi. There were two Egyptians who said they were Salafi, and there was an imam who claimed to be Salafi, but never gave da'wah according to the Salafi minhaj. They looked down on us. Anyways, fast forward, every time I went there, I felt that they looked down on me because I used to wear the thobe. Once I went to Medina to study, I realized that they were wrong. Anyways, if I was wondering if I should go to that masjid, because if I go, there's one old guy, he always talks, and he used to be very condescending to my father. The masjid is free mixed, you can say, and also there's no imam. And if I go there, they will tell me to lead, but I don't want to lead because these people will talk behind me. I guess meaning talk behind my back. There's a Salafi masjid here, but it's 45 minutes away and they aren't knowledgeable. I went there one time. It's like a click. Subhanallah. This is a big, full of issues. And I guess the crux of those issues that our brother is facing is, for one, it sounds like that he is a student of knowledge. He went to Medina and studied, it seems. And perhaps finished his studies, and that the masjid that is closer to his home is free mixed, and also, which I don't know exactly what that means, if it means the women are praying right next to men, or it's just not really the barriers you'd like to see, or what, I don't know. And that the people will talk behind your back. And the other option is a masjid that's very far away, which is a masjid which ascribes to Salafia, but has, I guess, a lot of issues of Hizbeeya involved in the masjid, meaning that they operate like a clique in a group and a sect instead of operating by the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, according to the madhab of the Salaf. So this is what I'm assuming according to your question. So what I would say, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best from sitting with our ulama and asking these kind of questions and reading and researching some of these issues, is that first, since the people respect you, obviously there is that you have some respect, that even if that masjid has bid'ah, even if it's a masjid of Ahl Bid'ah. Oh, Khalid Green is calling to Ahl Bid'ah. We can hear it now. Oh, Khalid Green is saying, be with Ahl Bid'ah. We hear that and we've heard it. So even if it's a masjid of Ahl Bid'ah, and even if they have whatever mistakes, because that's just the reality of the masajid of the world. You're not going to find, you will rarely find, when the numbers of masajid, you'll find a very few that are really Salafi, if you will, and where the whole community is ascribing to the Dawah to Ahl Sunnah. There isn't, we're not going to say there's millions of masjids like that. No, there could probably be thousands, I don't know, around the world. And so, with that being the case, Allah did not command us to cut off from the Muslims. وَاَعْتَسِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Hold on all of you steadfast to the rope of Allah, and do not divide. Meaning, hold on to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which the Hablillah, as the Mufassirin mentioned, is the Quran. And some of them mentioned that it's the Quran and the Sunnah, or that it's Islam in general, which is Kitab wa Sunnah. And so, and the Jama'ah. So, we unite upon the Dawah to Ahl Sunnah. And we do not divide. Of course, we divide from bid'ah, and we stay away from kufr, and we stay away from those things which displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so, because these masail are very detailed, the bottom line is, and I asked seven of the ulama that are well-respected Salafi scholars, like Sheikh Suleiman Arhili, Sheikh Abdullah Obeylan, Sheikh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab al-Aqil, Sheikh, many mashayikh in Medina specifically, and some of them in Ha'il, about this issue. And all of them basically, to summarize what they said, was that it is built on, like many of these masail, Masalih wa Mufasid, is looking at the harms and the benefits. And from what you say, it seems that it is more benefit than harm by you praying in that masjid. For one, it's closer, because you're going to miss many salats if it's 45 minutes away. That's just the reality. Number two, by praying closer, they respect you. You're the imam. This is a majal. This is an opportunity for you to give them da'wah. It doesn't mean everyone's going to rush to da'wah to Ahl Sunnah, da'wah to Salafiyah. But you are going to, with hikmah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us, to preach with beautiful and wise preaching, call them to the Sunnah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لِنْ يَهْدِيَ اللَّهُ بِكَ رَجْلٍ وَاحِدٍ خَيْرٍ لَكَ مُحَمِّرَ النَّعْمِ, that if one person is guided to Allah by your hand, it's better for you than the red camels. And the red camels to the Arab, and even still to this day, especially where I live here, you find that the camels are great a prize possession. Some of them go for like $1 million for a camel. We can't relate to it, but they pay definitely R1 million and things like this, R2 million. I've heard these figures. So let's say $500,000 for a camel and things like this. So they prize them tremendously. So it shows us that by guiding people to Islam and guiding people to Allah and guiding people to the Sunnah, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with Sabila Mu'mineen, which is Sabila Salaf al-Saleh, which is the path and the minhaj and the madhab of the Salaf al-Saleh, Ridwanullahi alayhim, that this is nothing but khair. It only comes with khair. So if there is more benefit, which sounds like the case in your situation, to call the people in this local masjid, because they allow you to lead the salat. You're not going there and you're not praying behind it. I've had to pray, especially in a local place where I stay when I go to America. The masjid is more or less, the heads are kind of Deobandi. There's all kind of things going on in there. And I have to pray behind the imam. He's competent to pray. He doesn't have any belief of kufr that I know of. So it's a valid salat, and it's the closest salat. Otherwise, I won't be able to really pray a lot of the salats in the masjid. So the point is you're looking at the harms and the benefits. And it sounds to me that there's more benefit because they respect you and you are going to lead the prayer. On top of that, that opens an opportunity for you to give some da'wah, to give a kalima. Just quote a hadith right after, something that's going to call the people to good. That's going to entice the people to come closer to Allah Azza wa Jal. That's going to call the people to iktisam bihablillah. That you're going to call the people to hold on to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a khair azim. So from that janib, I would say it's better. And if, with you being a talib al-ilm, perhaps you can even go to that Salafi masjid and slowly, because again, da'wah is with his hikmah. It's not going to come overnight. Sometimes you're in a very obstinate community that's far from the sunnah, but you don't know what 6 months, 1 year, 10 years will bring. You don't know. And that's why our da'wah is da'wah. It's not about cutting and destroying and just cutting off everyone, but rather we need to call the people to the book in the sunnah, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Think of how many of us were not Salafi. Once I used to flirt with Sufism. That lasted about a day or two, for all I can remember, maybe a month at the most. That wasn't really happening. I was influenced by Milestones and the Takfiri Dawah of Faisal to a degree, but it just never sat. You know, that stuff, my heart didn't take that, because he spit kufr and takfir. It's like you just wondered, is there such a thing as a Muslim? And this is the scary thing about, and I can't believe people, the way they insult and defend Faisal, it amazes me. That guy, I can't think of a takfiri, someone who fits the criterion of being a takfiri, more than him. I would say Abu Qatada Filistini and those guys, because they have more knowledge and more edeb, manners and stuff like this, they're a little bit more reserved, and they'll come at least with a janib of ilm with their takfir and their wickedness, because there's wickedness in making takfir without the right to do so. But Faisal, it amazes me. So I was influenced by that type of da'wah too. We went through stages and we grew in Islam. So you've got to have that humbleness, which I don't see from a lot of brothers, to go to the people and call them to the book of Allah. Remember where you were. Did you come out and you enter Islam and you were Salafi? Some people were blessed with that. They were blessed in those communities. Many of us who are far from those kind of communities, we ping pong from anything, many things, and it's a blessing that Allah guide us to Kitab or Sunnah. So with that being the case, it's very important to use that opportunity. Lead the Salat. Take that opportunity. Keep on your toes in your da'wah. This is going to make you to make muraja. This is going to help you to make revision and to call people to khair. Because you can only receive really good, at least with Allah Azza wa Jalla, if you're calling to Him and it's with ikhlas and ala sunnah. A last point I want to mention, because I just read some interesting posts and I see so much division, unfortunately, with some of the people from who claim Salafiyya. The dislike, the hatred, the infighting, it amazes me. And then I see a group of brothers, walillahi alhamd, and they're all over. I know enough du'at in the UK from all the camps, from those brothers with Salafi pubs. I know enough of those guys who graduated and went there, and I've been in Yemen with some of those guys, and I know. And I know enough of the brothers on the other poles and brothers who operate in those various Croydon and Brixton and all these other masajid. And what I will say is, walillahi alhamd, that there is Ahlul Sunnah, there's people calling to the book and the Sunnah and who are dealing with the issues of the communities all over, that are not busy with those infighting and all that garbage all the time, and busy in the people. And people are in the same dawah, disagreeing over one scholar. Look at all this fitna that, and I'm going to mention it, that we see about this issue of the Sa'afika and between Muhammad bin Hadi and Sheikh Rabi and this one and that one. I don't see this much benefit. Not even that much. And especially for the general Muslims to be in that. It's no benefit. Benefit from the ulama. Benefit from the ulama of Ahl Sunnah. And stay away from the controversy and fitna. And that's the tarbiyah that they gave us. That's what Imam Abdul Masin used to give us. That's what Imam Saleh Suhaimi, and used to sit with him, go to his office and sit with him, just me and him. And this is what the tarbiyah they gave us. You know, going to those mashayikh, Sheikh Mohammed ibn Abdul Wahhab, going to his house. Sheikh Ibrahim, I sat under his beard for years. Sheikh Suleiman al-Rahili sat under his beard for years, and he lived close by me. I'd catch him at the Starbucks masjid, walk home with him. Sheikh, what about this? Sheikh, what about that? That's not the tarbiyah they gave us. So don't be fooled by that foolishness. And don't run and rush to those statements. And this is the statement I want to deal with. And I'm sorry to get off point, but I just read it on a post on one of a comment, which it's a very common thing. Everybody is always claiming about certain du'at of Ahl Sunnah that they're sitting with the people of Ahl Bid'a. Well, how in the world are you going to call the people to the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? I'm not saying you go and swim and mix in and squeeze in and jump in, but the problem is people have so much skepticism. There's no husn al-dhan, and they're quick to call everyone Ahl Bid'ah. So no matter, you can never please anyone unless you sit with them. And as long as you don't sit with everyone else. This is the problem. So this is where things have just gotten crazy and out of hand. And I hear people talking about qawaid. Go back to those qawaid. This is what you're going to find from those qawaid of the Salaf. It's not one janib. You're going to see the Salaf, they dealt with these principles and these principles of fiqh, looking at the harms and the benefits. They didn't treat everyone in the same. Every scenario was not the same. Even dealing with Ahl Bid'ah differs in different time, difference in different places, different in different situations. All of those things have to be looked at. That takes ilm wa fiqh. If you don't got ilm wa fiqh, then yeah, you're going to just, everything's going to be black and white. Ahl Bid'ah, Ahl Sunnah. Only Ahl Sunnah because we agree with them. Ahl Bid'ah, they disagree with us. Doesn't matter that he's takfiri, he's this, he's this, he's this. And this one who even takes from our same ulama, he's with them. Come on now. Look at those criteria and those principles, and let's go back to the Sunnah. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.